Welcome back, everybody, here to our final game of the night for the ESL 1 coverage for this wonderful evening. We are here to give you the Dogs versus Relax, the final matchup to see who is possibly able to claim the number one position. If Team Dog actually take this game out, we have potential for a one-way tie and then maybe even a tiebreaker after that, depending on the results coming out for the remainder of this group stage. Or we could see Relax put it beyond contention and bring Team Dog down and take themselves a wonderful 4-0 lead as far as victories go, which would ensure themselves the number one position here in the group. Well, if they win one more game, of course. Let's get ourselves directly into the game. It's already up and running, so draft time, and the man who is showing his stamina this evening is Real Boris, man. Last game of the night.
Heck yeah, it's getting easier now because I'm starting to wake up, you know? This is when I wake up right now.
That's wonderful. This is when I start falling asleep. So, hey, together we actually find ourselves in a conscious state.
Nice. We have equilibrium here. We've established it.
I like it. I won't like this draft and what comes out from it right now, man, because so far we're starting off with the bans of Invoker and Lycan from Dread. This is just him trying to bait the Batrider, heavily bait the Batrider through for himself.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering if Pycat's going to let him have it.
What's your least favorite hero to play against right now in the meta? Tuffy, isn't it? I hate playing against... Well, I was going to say Terrorblade, but I meant in this meta and for Captain Jones.
Yeah, I'd have two different opinions on this based on, like, if you're talking... Oh, Yashiban Sanaga? Okay. The other Fireboy. We have Ember Spirit come through. Because I was going to say, like, if you're talking about, like, frustration heroes as far as this meta goes in the competitive scene, I would want to throw Lycan or Ember Spirit very highly up. If I'm talking about inside a pub game, Phoenix can burn.
Oh God!
And actually not respawn. That'll probably be the highest thing.
Spirit of our times.
Yeah, he really is. He really is. God. Phoenix is a joke of a hero, an absolute joke of a hero.
And they just need to. Okay, you just can't have the slow on his attack speed, and then the hero is actually fine.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. It's like having Napalm, but four times as effective. It's like, well, now you got to try and kill him when he goes into his ultimate form, but wait, no, you can't do that because you're taking too much damage from standing around him. And don't worry, he'll actually be able to jump to any position in this huge-ass freaking arc, which he's able to do, and then throw his ulti down in the middle of your team. So you've got an amazing repositioner, you've got attack slow with damage and a turn rate slow as well, and then so much other crap. Hero is described in that exact word, crap.
Crap. Best offlaner, you mean? Most annoying, obnoxious offlaner.
For people that have actually heard me play with Sing Sing over the previous weeks, you'll understand my hatred towards Phoenix. He's a douche. But Relax... They have themselves, I don't want to say the king of douches, but we have ourselves the man. Axe is here, man. Dread, they're bringing him back. Third time tonight out of their four games, they bring in the Axe. They've got the Ember Spirit as well. And that's actually a lethal combination in itself. Ember Spirit, the fist into the chain to catch maybe one or two heroes next to each other. And then Axe, an instant call after that point. It's almost certain death, and you've even got the work down that you got range harassment from the fist with the chain, and then you're going to have battle hunger on top of that if he decides to level up, because we have been seeing like the Axe only get 1 point up in battle hunger the entire time. But you've got such a great combination, jumping combo. It still, however, requires farm, but then again, Sentinel needs a blink, Axe needs a blink, and Morana needs farm for DPS, so everyone in this game is going to need farm coming into the mid-game so far.
I like what they're doing, just... having Axe versus Centaur so far, and I think it's been working out really well. The only hero, they had to pick the Bane there, and that kind of baited out maybe this tree pick or something, because now they only have, like, single target damage, which I think Relax is, like, picking Dog into a corner right now for sure, because if you don't have Shadow Demon, what else are you going to get with Morana, like, to set up? So they have a lot of single target, which counter that with tree right now, and... it's looking really good for Relax now, and they did this earlier. They did Axe and Tree.
Yep.
I forgot what their first hero was. It wasn't Ember, but I think it might have been Invoker or maybe Batrider.
I'm looking it back up again. They had Tree Axe. There was a Quap in one of the lines with the Naga and the Rubik.
Ah, that's right. They take Naga, Axe first.
And the other combination was when they ran Shadow Shaman, Storm, Axe, Lycan, and Vengeful Spirit. So we get the Rubik combination. This was that aggro tri-lane you could look at, telling you to drive back into Leech Seed and then into a Call. So simple abilities to get kills. But Dog also, I think, they've done a nice little pickup here with the Viper. So Ember Spirit is going to be careful about just how much harassment damage he wants to dish out at the Viper, because it could just turn badly on him. Because Karumi, if I'm wrong, but every time the Searing Chains ticks on him, he refreshes up the corrosive skin effect on himself. I know it's not a huge amount in comparison to the damage the Searing Chains does, but there's at least some kind of rebuttal coming out from the Viper.
I'm just scared how they're going to take towers right now because of the tree, and the Ember Spirit can go just safe lane right now since they can do Axe off lane and just
they could just get a Lashrak. Like, get Bane, Marana, Lashrak. I know it's old school, but you could try that in the aggro. Try and leave Centaur up on the top and put Viper in the mid.
Or Rasta or one of those two. I don't think a Sand King or another stun is going to work.
I would worry too much about having something like the Shadow Shaman in this game, because I just see him dying straight away, and it completely it shows Ember. The fact it's going to be a Centaur on an offlane, and that's his death. With Rubik Telekinesis as well as Leech Seed, they can slow him down enough. If he comes out just far enough, he'll go down. So if Centaur doesn't get the early ward, he has to abandon the bottom lane. Like, was he going to do
stack up Ancients? They're just committing like five men. Like, Dog's lineup right now, they're committing to the five men. They're absolutely committing with.
But they need the levels for that. Centaur's going to get harassed out by, be it Rubik or Treant Protector. And Treant will have a one-on-one fist fight with Centaur. No, Treant Protector is literally Hitmachan. He'll come in there and just beat the crap out of Centaur.
Karate chop his ass.
I actually think, if we wouldn't break the law completely, I'd want to have a boxing glove set for the Treant Protector.
That's pretty cool, actually. He just, swings and, that's a one-hit KO almost.
Yeah. Want to call him?
No, Disruptor.
Treant Protector. He's our Italian stallion.
Hello. My name is Italian Stallion. I can't do it now.
No, you can't. No, you can't.
I'm Rocky. What are you talking about? Shut up, Toby.
It's not even real dialogue. Wait, that was the movie. Disruptor pickup now from Doggy. So Team Dog, they'll get the Disruptor, Bane, and Marana together. Not 100% sure about the combination. Because I was looking for something else. Like, that's not our push we're looking for. It kind of goes with what you're saying, the five-man approach for Team Dog. It's an all-or-nothing kind of strat, it feels like, for them. If they get early kills, they can roll with a large amount of momentum. If they don't, they're going to get rolled by Relax. There's too much life on this team. There's too much stability. There's too much maneuverability as well from Relax. And now, oh, holy Hannah.
Agfa's Ember.
Who needs Battle Furies and Ember Spirit when you can have Magnus?
Just get four Battle Furies with that Empower. Would that one-shot the team if they get RP'd?
I don't think... It doesn't stack like that, does it? It's...
Well, they're all clumped up. So if... Say you have three heroes clumped up, they get hit each individually time, a numerous amount of cleavage. Because the cleave is going to do more than the original damage done on the first target. So you just keep cleaving for more damage on the enemy hero.
But would you need the Battle Furies when you have the Empower buff up? One is still
you'd
great.
You farm faster, and you probably don't need it. He might need a rush of Lincolns this game, which would be really good.
You're talking
or
about,
you can
you're
just
talking
go
about the
Daedalus or Deso. I don't know. Deso's not that good anymore. Maelstrom's okay rushing if you just want to get maybe some quick procs. But what I've been noticing is probably the best is Daedalus or Battle Fury.
I just got this image right now. Hang on. Does Mjolnir actually proc from return damage?
Proc from return damage? I don't... No,
because if they have grouped them all up and he's doing cleave damage, the possibility of actually creating a lightning storm right on top of Dog is quite high.
You could just put it on the Axe. I know Bobo likes to do this a lot. He gets Mjolnir on Axe. You just call and then you just rape. I'm not even joking. If you get two or three heroes, your attack speed with the Mjolnir with the return damage is just ridiculous. Or if you get the spins,
That's an awesome combo. Okay, I'm going to suggest that one. I don't know if, I guess I know we have our resident axe expert here in the office, and that's Jacob Melk. He plays nothing but axe all the freaking time. That's not true. That's a complete lie. He just plays a lot of it. I don't know if he's ever tried Mjolnir on that hero. Either way, it's a beautiful combo from Relax. I think for all the matches we've seen from Relax tonight, has there been a single time where we've gone, oh, that draft's a little bit shaky? Because to me, I can't remember a moment like that.
I think they're just definitely outpicking, and then they definitely out-execute their teams. And they did a last game, and then... last game, it was kind of even, but with the, like I said, the dire advantage for Luna, that's just sealed the nail in the coffin, and they shut down the Spectre enough to secure Luna's farm. So this game, I don't know. It's like an all-in thing. Yeah, my dog. It's just... how's it going to work out? It's going to be like on the backs of maybe this Disruptor catching out the enemy team or this Bane trying to find a Fiend's Grip.
But is that really going to be enough?
This tree is just going to do work.
My main concern right now for Team Dog is the fact that they don't do an aggro try. The Centaur gets zoned out. Oh, hello, we're going to have an answer. Mjolnir's magical damage as well as physical damage. So Centaur's return should proc it. Lightning storm in space. It's freaking Star Trek.
Easy.
Star Trek all over again.
Too bad Centaur's on the other team.
Yeah. Wait, what?
Centaur's on the Dire.
No, you're missing it. You make your own lightning storm by having the... Because every time you get the cleave damage, it should hit Centaur. So it could technically actually just keep proccing the Mjolnir on the Ember Spirit as he jumps in.
Right.
So, all
right, I get it now.
That's what I'm talking about. The damage which is dealt, then returns, and then procs.
That's pretty imbalanced.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. The other option is there is no Mjolnir, and Ember Spirit kills himself on the back of Centaur. but return doesn't do that much damage.
Yeah, it does, like, nothing. It's extra. It's just like having a...
I remember I saw a set recently that actually got... it had a counter on it. And I can't remember who was it from. No, we only got one counter on the weapon of... he's killed one building with this Reaver on the Centaur MSS. I expect more from a Centaur. There was one which actually said... And I can't remember who had the set for it. But it would count how many times you kill somebody from return.
Just from return damage. Geez.
And he had 5 on the counter. Look at this going. Once is hilarious. Twice is freaking hilarious. Third is like rolling on the floor laughing. What do you do when you're 5? Like you excrete from 3 ends and just like tears flood.
Is that for only like pub matches, or could you do it in houses too?
It'll count pub games only. I don't think it actually counts. It doesn't count. Like nothing counts when you play like private lobbies.
Yeah, okay.
In matches like this, it counts because you have a tournament ticket attached to it.
Mm. But that's good to know.
Yeah,
I didn't know that.
Everything else is in pub games. Or else you just have someone stand in there and just like die to return damage all the freaking time. You could level up your items completely just by doing such a thing. So there needs to be some level of officialness to the games. All right, well, so I get my wish, man. I get my wish. It's an aggro try line coming out here from Dog. I really want to see how effective Misery is going to be here. So much rests on him. And MSS is actually going to run towards the middle lane. So they put the Centaur up against the Ember Spirit, or what they thought was the Ember Spirit. Maybe they didn't think it was the Ember Spirit, and they thought it was going to be the Magnus, because it is the Magnus. So we get Magnus versus Centaur, the Battle of the Hoofed. And up towards top lane is a dual lane. Dread, as well as Ember Spirit, will be going up against Fater as the safe lane Viper. Good luck, Axe. That's all I can really say. This Axe could get completely destroyed early on. And that's why he puts this down. Of course, so that warding did get discovered. No, it didn't.
They know that's there. They know...
They didn't see him plant it. The vision only cuts across here, so they may not be aware of it. But they definitely see it with Misery hovering around the Axe and... where's Axe headed? Is he just going to stack and farm? He's walking so slow, though. And Misery just wants to... Okay, he's going to watch and leech the experience. He's going to point up and glimpse as the first thing. So there's no Static Storm here. And we'll see how low Axe can get. Because this is his downside. He's going to drop so low while he's doing this farm. It can just be the easiest first blood ever created by Team Dog.
Wonder if he's going to notice the EXP.
He hasn't really got enough of them yet. And there's your Nightmare. Misery's going to get to the other side. In fact, yeah, look at it. Pass cuts through the tree line to block him in here. There's a quick spin, another spin, but they make sure he goes down with a glimpse in. But now Rubick tries to battle it. But that's not going to work. And they're going to mop up his camp, which he did all that hard work for as well. Two Rangers from the high ground. Oh, that's just insult to injury.
Well, at least he would TP back bottom now, and he's going to get a full wave. He's going to get no spins. No love. All right, now he's gets all the spins. No
but
CS though.
He's almost got to use, like, he's got to use at least two, three charges of his Tangos to repair the damage he just took from the Murano that came in. And he's also battling up against two supports in this bottom lane that are 2.5 levels in. And that makes Rubick's life a living hell. If they can get this Nightmare, the tree's already been cut. So pass, he gets himself in range. They've got Thunderstrike. And I hear an arrow coming in. Rubick move up fast enough. But with Thunderstrike in the back of him, this is another kill to Team Dog. This aggro tri lane couldn't have gone any better for him.
Yeah, they knew that they were going to go aggro tri lane, else they wouldn't have run the Ember top. They were just hoping that Axe wouldn't get scouted out like that. And yeah, it's good rotation so far. And it's going to be on the Ember and Magnus to create space for this Axe to get back in the game now.
It's hilarious to watch the battle of these big giants in the mid. Like, Magnus and Centaur, like, the double-edge at level 2, like, sliced off half of Magnus's life. And then he bottles up, and then you've got, like, a shockwave to throw back through the Centaur, which does so minimal damage. But you know the power of what happens if Crazy can skewer him back into the tower. Is he going to go again? I thought he may as well just double-edge him. I know there's still bottle charges available, but... No, he's sending it back and being a little bit safer about it all.
Well, they're rotating the lanes now. Disruptors are going to go up. So Axe should be able to get... They didn't find his D ward bottom for Rubick. That's unfortunate. So he can't help ward. But Axe is going to come back. He's level 3. He's going to be 4. He's doing fine in the jungle now. But
this,
the
this
Rubick
bottom
now
lane
has to be careful.
Abandoned.
Yeah.
But meanwhile, up on the top lane, though, the whole worst lane for Dog is what was actually a 1-for-1 fader until he did a neutral pull just then. Like, those extra CS he has.
CS.
Yeah, he's been destroyed in this top lane. 20 for 3 comes in for the Ember Spirit, and Fadus has absolutely nothing. But at the same time, he's a 1-1-1 across on the Viper, so getting a kill on him is actually rather still difficult for this lane. Even with
Leech Sleep. And Ember's going for the Flame Guard build.
I'm kind of surprised that. I thought he would go for a high level up in chains and just do it from range.
Yeah, too.
Oh. Either way, MSS just wasted a stomp. He's got a regeneration rune, so he doesn't really care. And that also means that Crazy could have sent the bottle back to base. Pycat's getting so much farm on this bottom lane. He's about to finish up his phase boots, while Pass is just trying to find the opening for him. Observer Ward's around the corner, and now Nightmare. Arrow, it should be in range. There's a creep! Oh! For the cause! For the cause! The mocking smile from Rush. Well played, creep. Well played, creep. But he knows he won't be as lucky next time. And you're already seeing Pass coming in, and you can see him. It's a simple Nightmare. They won't be really ready for the Axe or have returned to this lane just yet.
Oh, Centaur 6, actually. He's going to get the solo kill middle on this Magnus.
Wow, really? Comes in. No. Oh, missed the hoof stomp.
Close.
Oh, no, it did. He actually hit him, but he skewered away in time. I'm watching bottom lane instead. Nightmare. There's already a Searing Chain with the fist. The arrow fly in. Wow, Ember Spirit. Living armor. It kicks in. It's going to protect him because Axe got the call off. Pycat couldn't keep attacking him. He leap in, gives the movement speed over towards the Bane. But the living armor still has 3 charging up. Pycat, he wants to get close enough, but he can't. Movement speed, phase boots. There's no fist available. Starfall is up for Pycat. Another call's coming out, but Bane, he's got no mana. Centaur's on the way in, and maybe they can help out Murana. Again, another call holding Pycat position. A quick fist up. Ember Spirit gets the kill. Rubick was a trade-off, but so is the Axe. 2-for-1. battling up inside the jungle, but Team Dog brought almost everybody there apart from Fader.
Well, they're going to need to snowball. They're giving space to the Viper. That's one good thing, at least. Ember Spirit, level 5. He's not going to be doing that well this game, I think. He's not going to have enough. Yeah, he needs level 6, and he needs levels. That's why normally you put Ember mid, because if you just split levels, it's not going to work out. Middle lane.
At the same time, though, you need a levels he's over on the Magnus. Tipped. Glimpse? Where's Vision? Glimpse? No mana. He was short by 10 mana for it, so they couldn't just drag him back into a quick stomp. Arrow's going to have a bit of a fish now too, but no joy on it. Crazy was busy blocking the lane. But yeah, you're right. Fader did get a lot of space up in that top lane too. He's about to finish up his treads, which is nice for him. But not quite. It's definitely taken some time for him. At the same time, Dredd's also finding some good levels by just sitting up here on the top layers, keeping his distance, making sure he's still in experience range. But he just cracked level 5, so we've got 3 points up at the Living Armor, which makes every other lane so much more powerful for Relax.
As long as they can hold out, maybe, but the Smoke Gang's going to come bottom. I think he's going to get caught out. Revealed. Oh, he revealed. The ward's still up. It's about to end, though. And they just placed the ward there.
That Rubick almost attacked. It doesn't really matter. That ward had 3 seconds left on it, so who gave a crap if he revealed the fact it was there? He could have, in fact, wasted a sentry from Team Dog.
Yeah, they know they awarded down there. Good D ward here.
Can they get there in time? Nightmare, it's in range. Oh, just popped out of range at the end of it.
They still have...
Did we lose him? I think we lost him again. This time I actually noticed to cut him off halfway through sentence. The bottom lane's going to keep being forced out. I'm hearing a Centaur ulti right now. Looks like just an escape from the middle lane. Feeling the pressure coming in his way. But nothing really made of it on the bottom lane either. So it was just a defensive Centaur ulti. But they're going to try and force out the tower. Now Pycat could go for a fishing arrow. Ember Spirit's considering jumping down for this. And there's more support on the way in. Living Armor's protecting the tower at least from the catapult, and they do TP in support. MSS coming in through the rear. That's Rhea Boris us join us here on the phone call. But Centaur, actually, he's found an extra one. They got the axe out of position. They don't have to fight on bottom lane here, but the Searing Chain's going to go on Misery, and he gets nuked down. Same with Pycat, has to leap away. And now, well, Centaur's waited a long time to throw out this stun. And now, well, the skewer back, RP is available. Once the Centaur reveals himself, oh, the arrow connects on Axe. Now, well, there's your Centaur stun. Splits the Magnus up, so there's no RP available. Living Armor will protect the Rubick as he runs away after stealing the Bane kill with the Fade Bolt. Double kill coming in there for Windex. And Pycat just moves back into the tree line, cuts his way through. Ember Spirit, not enough mana to really turn, try and fight this one. That's why Centaur, oh, leaves a Spirit behind him. He's not going to go back in. That's just a weird fight. Like, Axe could have got picked off a long time beforehand, but it looks like the call never came out. Team Dog committed onto the fight on the bottom lane. Did that get initiated by Relax? Did I miss something?
Yeah. Relax initiated Ember Spirit onto Misery. He got caught out of position. He was here where the creep wave is, and he got caught at the tower.
Couldn't reach him. Not with the Centaur ulti. He escapes away. Well, that would explain why Team Dog was fighting in two different locations at the same time. Movement coming
bottom
up.
Lane.
There's already the call right now on Bane. Well, he's got Nightmare available. He's already faked it once, and the arrow from Pycat. He was expecting the Nightmare to be there. He has a Nightmare over on the Axe, however, and Bane, not healthy. Culling Blade to go through from the Axe. Nice high movement speed, but Moonlight Shadow trying to protect him. But not fast enough. And still, Viper is not involved. All of these Viper fights are happening without him. Misery, you're dead. Battle Hunger, movement speed. Arrow, it'll connect on Axe, no high movement speed, but Skewer, wow, it's a long way up. RP, okay, I'm not quite sure that was worth the commitment. Either way, they will get the kill on Misery.
Yeah, I told you, like, this is a 5v5 lineup. You can't have the Viper, even though he's been shut down a little bit. He still has treads, and he has, like, string treads will be, like, 950 HP or 1,000. And he has his ulti, and he can run down people. He's just farming up his Blink Dagger, and he's not pressuring the top tower either.
Viper? You mean Centaur is farming Blink?
No, the Viper. Did I say Blink?
Yeah, you said Blink. Viper's going mech, Centaur's going mech, Blink. And yeah, Centaur has his Blink. The arrow is a 5 second stun over on the Rubick for now, but then a tree ulti, three to catch out. There's a Centaur who just jumped straight over the top of him. Couldn't find anybody. Now he'll double-edge down the Rubick and trying to go a little bit deeper. Hoof stomp too far away. And now he'll throw out the Centaur ulti. Tries to go on the Ember Spirit. He got the stun off. Ember's out of mana. And then Fiend's Grip over on the Axe. A full team wipe with a triple kill going the way of MSS.
Nice Blink there. Yeah, they fought that without Magnus ulti. And then the Viper TP'd in this time. And even though he went down, he still helped. And I don't know. I don't think they should have engaged. They were like all the ways diving past the tier 1 tower. And that just hurt them. But happens, and this Centaur, he's got 1,000 gold on top of him, and they're gonna get this tower. Magnus is not even close to his Blink. Neither is Axe. Actually, he's got 800 away.
That's still that's like a blind Axe jumping in. Tranquil Boost isn't enough to protect an Axe when he's blinking. It'd be great to have it, but I see him dying just as quick as when he jumps in. Because any damage which he dishes out, it's now going to be repelled by the mech when Fader finally finishes that. Now middle lane. It's a nightmare over on the Axe. Extra TP coming in. Shockwave, a little bit too early. Centaur stomp. Whee! Okay. He got cold and then ran into the trees.
That was hilarious. I don't know how he ran into the trees. Dred's dead top. Fada's going to get a kill.
Solo work. Even if he RPs right now, I don't think he's got enough damage with an RP. Well, he canceled the TP at least, but Fader, he's really tanky on this one. Now with Centaur ulti, he's got a high movement speed. They waste Crazy's ultimate, and then Moonlight Shadow of Fader. He tried to dodge the second shockwave, and unsuccessful at doing so. Yeah, but I noticed some weird things too with Axe's Call. This is something I just found. I don't know if it's just a bug or something, but I know like when you have like Legion Commander and Axe trying to work together, it screws everything up. It's like you must duel me, but you also must attack them. So it kind of screws that one up. But yeah, there's definitely something going really weird with Berserker's Call of Light.
Yeah, I think it's just a TP thing. When sometimes the TP messes up, I feel like messes it up or something. Some interaction with that. But this Ember Spirit is just not doing too well this game, and they're finding a way to shut him down because he wasn't middle lane, and I think that's basically what's hurting them the most. It's just that they thought the Centaur was going to be top and the Viper mid, so they decided to just switch lanes, and it's been paying off for them.
Well, Rubick managed to steal just them. One level of Nightmare. Doesn't seem like much, but it's going to cause some troubles during the fights. And Pycat, arrow to fly, and he's going to get... Crazy dodges at the last moment. That would have been the 5 second stun. They wouldn't have been a follow-up, because you've still got both Rubick as well as Treant there. And with the Nightmare over on that Rubick, they would have just Nightmared up the Magnus and protected him.
Mojo is 5-0 right now. He's doing a lot of work on the Centaur, and that's not work I was talking about. I'm never praising you again.
Do you feel the jinx? Do you feel the jinx?
Time to die, Mojo. Just go die. Just go die.
Is he like being called Mojo or MSS?
His old name is Mojo Stormstout, but he just shortened it to make it easier. I think either's fine. I just like calling him MSS sometimes when he has a name like this, but Mojo is what I think he's more known for.
I'm just wondering, because everyone, like every caster I know, calls him MSS. But I don't know what he actually prefers. Should ask him one time. Mission, find out.
All right.
There's smoke coming in towards the middle lane. They're about to jump, and they're going to find Crazy. Quick Hoof Stomp, but a faster Blink. That was very quick. That wasn't even just a double tap. That was a positional hit. Now Searing Chain's over on Fader. Has to take the Shockwave. He's almost going to pop the mech to keep himself alive. As Dire Sentry Wards go down, I think they just saw it at the last moment. Yeah, Windex goes in there to mop it up. And now the rest of Dog aren't sure about this, but when they get the stun on Magnus and then Centaur ulti, they have more than enough damage with the extra Starfall. And then the Fiend's Grip over towards the Rubick. It's perfect control coming out from Dog. Viper trying to slow down the Ember Spirit. Glimpse and drag him straight back. And now Tree ulti catching in a couple, but Nightmare, it didn't catch pass. He moves in. Centaur stop. The double edge. I thought they might even hit on Ember Spirit as he jumped in at the last moment. But MSSGO is unstoppable on the Centaur. 6-0-2 for the Centaur. And they will take the tier 1 tower for Team Dog.
They're just getting out-initiated on these teams. Like, Magnus got caught out there because of the nice arrow and kind of out of position. And is anybody else going to get caught out? Nope.
Well, if Axe ran straight back to base, he would have. But he also just purchased his Blink Dagger, so he doesn't want to go back to base just yet.
Well, maybe with this, they can start initiating better onto Dog because... And, well, they still don't have a mech either, so I'm liking Dog's chances even more and more. They've managed to take down two towers, and they're doing really well, up 6 kills, and we'll see how this Axe initiate goes. Maybe he'll get 3 or 4 people, turn the tides.
As long as he spins. As long as he spins. Then he's got a chance. If they need that damage to come quick and hard. Without that, they got nothing. Fade is moving up to the top lane. Just to farm up a little bit more. Ring of Aquila, Magic Wand, Mech. Find some extra levels more than likely. Maybe he can finally get to a point where he can consider having the Aghanim Scepter. Or maybe just having a level 3 ulti.
Like, if you look at the CS this game, it's just like, you would never see this in like a competitive game normally. It's just so much aggression being pumped out from Dog that they're doing the right thing, just not giving them any time to breathe. Ember Spirit's finally being able to push out a lane by himself, so they're just keeping up the pressure, and it's nice.
Oh, Axe, there's your jump in on Fader, but the arrow flies in, the creep wave will tank it up, the Centaur slices him, as well as stomped him to start.
I don't think that was too smart anyways, since he has mech and he can slow you with the ulti, plus yep. Your team's not going to come with backup, so not the smartest idea. He didn't even have a TP either, so he couldn't have TP'd out if Viper had ultied him.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And where was the support? He didn't have enough damage to kill the Viper. It's crazy. Centaur, a little bit of a misclick there. I think he meant to blink and then stomp, but didn't really find it. Meanwhile, we've got Mirana, Invis Rune doing all the scouting behind the lines, and they see Crazy back here. So he's just doing vision scouting right now, and then he'll get a follow-up stun. But the Invis is wearing off. They need to go now. They need to go, like, right now. And there's already the first blink back. But Windex is still too close. Starfall, arrow, easy combination. And the last attack from the Viper will get the kill. So they're intercepting the creep wave halfway through. In the meantime, Ember Spirit is pushing at the bottom lane. So we are still looking at trade-offs here. As far as damage to the towers. Now Ember wants to come top lane and farm. Fight. Blink Dagger RP is required. They get the call over on Bane, and now your RP catches 3. They've got to skewer him back, however. The Fiend Scrim tries to go, and he drags 4 back into the hit. Ooh. Now that hurts. That hurts like hell for Team Dog.
Dang, you got the Fiend's Grip off, but the Searing Chains canceled it, and he was able to skewer it back. So well played by the Bane, but even better play by the Ember Spirit setting up that. And then he didn't even need a dunk. He got some nice spins there at the end.
Yeah.
Got the dunk on Centaur, though, to get his streak. So that's actually worth it. They got a tower and they killed 4 of them. I don't know if they should keep pressuring, though, here, because they're all coming back.
Well, we're stolen.
But they want to.
They just stole Viper Strike. So there's a chance. Windex can just throw it out here. He's already telekinesis him, and now they're in trouble. They've overcommitted themselves. Windex will die here. Living Armor won't protect him, and they kill off Windex to start with, and then the Nightmare breaks free of Dread. Arrow was coming down. It's a little bit too late. No Searing Chains. It was attempted then, but now Skewer over on Misery. Drag him in closer. Well, that glimpse didn't really do much, but Centaur, that'll do a lot more. Double edges him up. The ulti will fly out there from the tree and protect it, holding 3 in position. And Ember Spirit, he needs to jump to his spirit. He jumps up, he jumps down, but they're sticking with him. Another quick chain. It's over on the Bane, the call. He needs to spin. Spin it like a top. Spin it like a top. Something spin. Ember Spirit, now he jumps in. Oh, he just couldn't find it.
That's horrible. How do you not get any spin? Oh, buyback. Axe. Doug.
Yeah, this time you'll get it. The Culling Blade, it comes back in for a double kill. He's already used his call. 4 seconds off cooldown in a moment. If he gets a Battle Hunger on Misery, you'll have the movement speed. There's a Battle Hunger in with the Legion Seed, but he gets glimpsed back down again. And the arrow from Pycat was looking to try and connect it. And now Axe is a little bit too close. Pycat's going to come in. Starfall with the poison, with the Thunder Strike, and the negative Earn Charge. They got themselves a kill.
And just a little bit overstaying their welcome. If Axe didn't get a good call off there, I think Dog would have won that fight because they overcommitted. They shouldn't have tried to go for that tier 1 top, but
yep.
Now it's on Dog to see if they get more aggressive, and Arrow almost catches Windex. But slides by.
You know, no. These fights are going to get even harder for Team Dog in the future. Like, Axe Cold is one thing, but the Mag RP is another thing when combined with almost, I'm not going to say a full Battle Fury, because he's not there yet. So he's 1K towards the 2600 he requires. But it's the fact you've also got the Empower, which is already going to give that early cleave over to the Ember Spirit. So he's got ways of farming up just that little bit faster. But we're looking at the cleave, which we were searching for before, with a fist, the cleave, to go through Team Dog.
Yeah, I think it's the best. He could still go Lincoln's Fear, too, if he wants to. But I think they have enough survivability with Axe Blinken, Mag Blinken, to where Ember can just stand on the back line and just easily harass them.
Yeah. And this game's kind of turning into a... It's not, let's just try and survive. It's, if you can kill them fast enough, you'll win the fight. That's what it feels like this is just turning into.
Now, soul farm, though.
Marana Rolti. Like,
Weaver. He's got a Reaver already. 21 minutes in with a blink, so.
They saw Crazy go into the tree line. And now there's double two. Stomp. Double stomp and the double edge. The arrow's going to fly in, and it hits on the axe. That's at least 4 seconds on him. Living armor, now the RP. Only is on Pycat, but they'll skewer him back in range of the tier 2 tower. Leap away for Pycat, even though he got called. Disruptor throws the ulti down. Now Pycat, Centaur ulti, and the Meg charge. Viper's trying to go in deep, and we'll be picking up the axe here in this fight.
Pain's gripping him. They're going to pick off Yoki.
MSS almost kills himself at the end of that. Oh, and the shockwave! He blinked into the tree line and got him. Now he's trying to win power buff up. They know he's in there, but they can't reach him because he can't get at himself until the blink's off cooldown. Top tower is under attack. Nice yeah. Snipe by Crazy.
If Ember Spirit had more mana, that's fodder.
It's a little bit too late that arrow to connect on the mag.
Yeah. For some reason I thought fodder might have been mag.
Fader has now changed teams. Wait, no, that was meant to happen before. Is he part of
it? Are you saying that there's a new team called Dogma or something?
I Sigma? No.
Sig Dog?
Sig Dog? A Sig Dog. See, that doesn't make any sense right there. But I'm happy they're actually playing under the name of Team Dog as opposed to, like, you saw all the troubles that was being made in the WPC, European qualifier. Because it was just like, it was Sigma, but they were Team Dog. So Joined It was like one of the only match tickers out there that was labeling them as Team Dog as opposed to Sigma because their roster was Team Dog's roster.
Yeah.
But the reason why they were playing under Sigma was because all the overlays for the Chinese were made for Sigma. And they didn't want to change all their overlays for just the European qualifier.
Well,
reason why.
We'll see. This, I mean, they're doing fine as a new team. They're going to get this Roshan. They're still going to have a lot of kinks to work out, but I think they're doing fine. They've been doing fine recently. The one thing I have a problem with is that they're in the American Dota League, and they have 4 Europeans. Not going to say anything about that.
Qualifying for the summit of the European division? It's like Cloud9. Like, Cloud9, the last season of the JDL, was playing in the European division. But for the MLG TKO, they were playing in the US division. And the reason they decided was, well, we're kind of sitting on the edge and we want to get experience from both regions. I'm like, I can understand that.
Well, Battle Fury's up. Ags is up on Viper, though. That might help them a lot in these team fights. Hard is almost up in 1,000. See, who has the mech? Oh, Misery's going to go for Ags. And he's actually...
There's a Fiend's Grip on mid lane, man. Windex, Hoof Stomp, just trying to control him. They had to work
Why
through.
Why is he so far up there?
He was looking for the last hit in the tower, I think, is the only thing I would go with. Because that tower is actually now within deny range by 9 damage. But it's a quick smoke by Dog. They don't want to let this tower go. Moonlight Shadow as well. They're coming in for a kill. The funny thing is, though, Magnus, he's Nature's Geist up. So he'll break the smoke, throws in a shockwave. Whoa. And now, Centaur ulti, they're going to go in deeper, searching for the kill over on the axe, dragging him back up again with a glimpse, and he is in the middle of the Den of Dogs. They will push into the tier 2 tower, and they will take this now. With Mag and Axe down, there's only, like, Fist, which would slow him down. If he comes close enough for that, it's just a straight Blink Dagger in for the Centaur.
That had to be the weirdest shockwave I've ever seen.
Did he do that blind as well? Because he couldn't have seen them, right?
I don't know. No, he couldn't have, and... It didn't even hit creeps or anything. That's I was just like, what?
Blink, arrow, orb, Piecat, you're in way too deep. Arrow then stolen, returned. Only 3 seconds on the stun, and now it's up to Faye to make the space. And maybe that's the reason
plus
why he was doing
damage
it.
On Ember.
He's going to need it to try and defend this. Starfall cleans up a little bit of the creep wave. But they got the tower down to 1/3 of his life points. They need to finish this. They're committing this much in. They've got to finish it. And they're not. They're backing up. Axe is up in 1 second. So they just pop the mech. But they might decide to try and turn a fight on this one. Relax already trying to come up. The arrow comes down though. Misses on absolutely everyone. Now Axe, blink in. He got the call over on Fader. Not the one they really need. And the Centaur, double Horb Stomp, brings down the Rubick. Ember Spirit jumps up. The Fiend comes keeping Mag out of play. He tries the RP, but no effect. He couldn't get it off in time before death. And now Fader called in again. Axe is looking for the dunk, but couldn't reach it. Not in time, too many life points. Now Nightmare, they're over to the Ember Spirit. Horb Stomp, Starfall, extra damage, 200. Look at the fist damage! He does a hell of a lot, but it's not enough. And Draco's invis, one fist pump, and you might get a kill on Pinecamp, but he gets arrowed up. He's still trying to chase down the kill, and then Horb Stomp, 39 life points. They got some other spam? Something to see him. Some kind of reveal. Something.
No more nukes.
He could TP out. And if he did that, he's in Nature's Guise, he's protected. But they've got 3 heroes down. RP is still available when he comes up in 8 seconds time, but this Living Armor hasn't done enough work to save the Tier 3 tower. It might be enough to stall him up.
Not enough time.
No Viper. He's coming down for Rubick. Glimpse him back. Horf Stomp. Double Edge. He's toast. And this now means they can't finish the Rax. And there's no point starting on the melee Rax because he'll just regenerate. So back it up. Look for. I won't say next Roshan. It's too long away.
That is a long time away. I mean, the Disruptor got 2 good Static Storm and Kinetic Field, and then with MSS, nice follow up there. So that set up the fight, and then the Ember Spirit almost pulled it back with the, like you said, the Empower plus the Sleight of Fist. If you just had like one more item or something, that would have been like 4 people. They're just getting too overconfident in these, and they're just like running out, trying to. They're just getting counter-initiated on.
They're playing like Russians.
Russians, yeah.
It's the Russian Dota. Chat trivia. Yeah. We'll ask the question first. Who are the only two players with 10 pro Dota 2 wins on record, or Centaur Warrior? And one's SEA, one's EU. Now jump in. Fader, there's already a nice searing chains over towards Fader. They use the Moonlight Shadow to try and protect themselves, and Fader, well, he goes all disco. Mjolnir effect is up on him, and Centaur, double stomp. They didn't get the extra chains to disrupt a good oldie. The RP working beautifully from Crazy Draking. 3 heroes back in range of the tier 2 tower, and another searing chains with a fist in, but the arrow, it brings down the axe. Magnus already on the sidelines. Fader standing his ground and surviving so much longer than he really should have. And now the Mjolnir effect is really kicking in, and Dread, well, he goes one way because of the glimpse back underneath the tier 2 tower. MSS will split him and then die to the tower. Wow, everyone's just throwing away their lives for this. Finally, they bring down the tower. And we go 36-17 right now. But Dog can't push high ground. Ember Spirit is still up, and he'll be able to slow it down. Battle Fury
Man,
and Crystallis.
Man, actually doing work. Sinfeeble is doing so much work.
Okay, now he's in trouble. Can they see him? Glimpse. They need to see him. There's the glimpse. It's dragging him back. The wall is there, and he's got nowhere to jump to. Fiend's Grip is still on cooldown, so they can't go in.
No Fiend's Grip or no arrow.
But it is nice having a level 4 Enfeeble over on the Ember Spirit when he tries to jump in. That damage at 102 plus 11. Huge.
Huge. It's doing a lot of work, actually. If he had more, he would have definitely won that fight, I think. Mm-hmm. So the Enfeeble has definitely saved them that fight, because they had a good initiation again with MSS and the good RP dragging 2-3 back, but it wasn't enough, so they just traded. Do they have a gem? They know there's a ward up there.
They gave him a sentry one. Yeah. And he needs to drop his TP scroll to pick it up. I suppose that's one way to do it.
Just one way. Here you go.
Trivia. What was it? It's, 10...
With Centaur? 10 wins?
10 wins on the Centaur. Well, the first thing you're going to say is, well, he said SCA, but I'm wondering if that's actually a trick hint, And if it's actually ice.
I mean, that's the only logical thing, because they're the ones who play Centaur the most, except for the last week or so.
Mm-hmm.
The Western teams haven't been playing.
Oh, Centaur ulti, they're coming in. The arrow's going to fly down too, but no jump in. And that Centaur's tanky. 2.7k life on him, with now with a heart. So he's got the regeneration on top of that.
He's going for a Shiva's probably, or a grass. Probably a Shiva's.
They're coming in. Axe, double call. This time, watch him spin. That's two. Pycat losing a lot of life. He's going to leave himself out, disrupt the bias of space with his ultimate, and they lock in the Axe. Double kill comes the way of Fader. He just stands his ground. The Meg charts help keep him alive, and now he can move over to Dread. There's a glimpse back, and it's over on the Ember Spirit. It was Nightmare up. One quick fist. He's put the Ember Spirit up, the Spirit up on the top on the high ground, but the Fiend's Grip is still there. So Ember Spirit locked in position. He's going nowhere, and Dread arrow will fly. That'll catch him even inside the invis, because the gem was actually over on past. They're throwing quite clearly, and Roshan even respawns now. But Dog, they're gonna be looking for high ground. Even if they just take out this tier 2 tower in the mid and they move up towards the top lane, either way, Arrakis shall die tonight.
Arrakis shall fall tonight. And I don't know what happened to the Magnus over here. Like, how, I didn't see where he died, sort of. He died to the right over here. It was really weird, because if they had him during that team fight, this is just Disruptor zoning, and they had he had an Ags that fight too, so he couldn't cast any spell items, but I didn't have any items to cast anyways. Maybe Blade Mill.
Ember's going to buy back. They're going to back out now. There's a jump. Past just trying to get himself away as quickly as possible. And I think I know the other one. Funnick. Put Funnick up on the list. I don't know if they've seen any other team that's played as offlane as much. There's no European team that comes to mind that makes me say, these guys always do it. Mag. And Ohio. Wow, okay. 6-2 and a 4-3, so at least... Well, okay, that's all a long way off the 10 victories. But Mag in Ohio, huh?
I can see that. Since our... I haven't been watching too much of Empire before Star Ladder. I don't know what they did before then. I just saw them during... They picked it a few times.
I'm having a mental blank after our long day, so I have nothing to help you out in this one. What I can tell you is, though, full AC has been purchased up over. Full Shiva's Guard is over on the Centaur. But that courier has the AC recipe, and that one belongs to Fader.
So much armor. Armor upon armor.
He's 300 gold away. I think he's waiting for the ancient stack, the ancient camps to spawn. Pick up his 300 gold, buy the AC. And then they go for a push in mid or top.
The only way they're going to win this game is if Ember gets a Daedalus plus another Battle Fury. That's the only way I can see them winning. Because they do have the initiation still with the Magnus. He needs his BKB, though. With the Ags from the Disruptor, though.
I'm still not going to go over the Battle Fury, man. I'm saying Empower 1 Battle Fury is enough.
Nah, it's never enough. You do so much more work with 2 Battle Furies. I mean, you could definitely get a Rapier probably over the Daedalus, but... Mass Crit Sticks?
Be down for that, too. If he can't get down to pick up the Demon Edge, he might just have to do that anyway. But whenever you pick up a Chrysalis, you have to sacrifice something else. Like, 15 wand charges, the Ring of Aquila. Do you really want to sacrifice these two things to pick up a Chrysalis only? Well, at least he's able to mop up creep.
That's a DD
waves.
Rune on the Centaur, too.
Creep, Windex, take out the creep. He ended up, Centaur jumping in for the Hoof Stomp. Leap was actually stolen there by the Rubick, and they got the chains over on the Centaur, but now he's the one to go disco during this fight. Gonna push in on the melee racks, and the ranged racks is the easier one to bring down right now. The regeneration is obviously kicking in, and now, well, Crazy blinks in for the skewer, but. Now puts that on cooldown, and the arrow connects on Rubick. 5 seconds RP, but it's only on one hero. Kree's going to be absolutely useless during this fight. And then Axe, he'll be the big man coming through. Big call coming up from him with the Blade Mail Reflect damage. And they're going to have a crack over maybe Fader. MSS jumps in for another one. Disruptor Aldi just is, for some reason, watering the grass. And they'll bring down the range racks. Another jump in by Axe. He goes on Pinecap. No spins. He puts up the Blade Mail again this time, but it's Ember Spirit who's in more trouble. Fader just started focusing him down, and they'll go in deeper. Shiva's Guard from MSS splits them up. The gem's on the deck right now, and Fader picks up so they can find Dread. They pull up from the corpse of their of the fallen comrade, and he drops down, and GG.
Yeah, Ember had no buyback. He bought back like 3 minutes ago, or 4 minutes ago. I forgot about that. Oh. With no buyback on Ember, I was able to claim the... That was as best as it could have went for Relax on that last team fight. Actually. Disruptor missed everything. They had killed off them with the Ember Spirit. They got a great initiation with Axe, 3-man call, 4-man call, almost. I think it might have been 4. And it wasn't enough. Too far ahead. Really well played. Evening up 1-1.
Well, man, we're going to wrap up our night. So, yeah, you're right. They level up 1-1, and that actually gives us a number one position draw with both Team Dog as well as Relax to have one game left to play. Now, they both sit at 3-1, and their last games are up against My Insanity, the crazy Serbians. The guys that bring in some rando strats and just give a loss where you never really expect one to have. So if Team Dog or Relax lose one game up against My Insanity, they'll find themselves in second position.
They beat Empire too, so they might have their work cut out for them. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah. Well, Team Empire, remember that was MMC, not My Insanity.
Oh, okay. Tonight. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, I see. Yeah.
So Team Empire find themselves in a rough position too, because they're drawn up with Meteor Makers in second position. But they'll have a chance to try and redeem themselves tomorrow. They go up against the Russians. We have ourselves a full Russian matchup. Empire versus Virtus Pro. That'll be our first match tomorrow. And Cloud9 will play one of only two games they have to play here in the group stage, because Sigma was forfeited out. They ended up going 0-6, so all the wins actually went default wins over to Cloud9. That actually causes a little bit more of a problem, because Goomba and Hee-Hee actually went 1-1 in Group D. So if Cloud9 lose a single game to one of these guys, they could find themselves out of that number one position, which means they don't have a chance to go straight into the semifinals, and they could find themselves going the long road through the quarterfinals as well, and that's not going to be an easy road with some of these teams qualifying through. So Cloud9 have their work cut out for them tomorrow. I believe we actually have three games coming up tomorrow. They're the first two, Cloud9 vs. Hee-Hee, and it looks like we have an MYM game. And MYM will be playing the last game of tomorrow night, and they'll be going up against MMC as well. So MMC will play their final match of the evening, and we'll have of the group stage, and we should have MYM playing the second last one. So great games coming up tomorrow night. Definitely tune in for that one. Thanks for tuning in tonight. Hope you've enjoyed the matches. You go to youtube.com/joindota for all our wonderful stuff which we do here on the Join Dota Red live stream. In fact, in all our live streams, be it across Dailymotion as well as our MLG live stream, we have the TKO VODs over there, the D2CL VODs over there, as well as anything else which is coming up will be put up on our YouTube channel, and the fun stuff. If you don't watch X Marks the News, we release a new episode today. So he does that one. We do the items of interest, looking at the awesome stuff from the community. I normally have a little bit of fun with Zoe when we do that one. And for some reason, too, we have singing videos now over on our channel. So a little bit of everything. A little bit of everything. And we should wrap up tonight with, last but not least, my co-commentator for this evening. Man, where do people follow you? What are you doing? What are you up to? How do people follow Riaboros?
You can follow me at RuboTZDota. All right, I'm just saying Riaboros from now on.
Hey, it just sounds so much better. How do you pronounce it?
It's RuboTZ. It's kind of weird.
Where's the pronunciation come from?
It's Japanese. It's means Dragon Ball Z. So you just, it's like Ru, it's dragon though. And you border Z, and then it's Ball Z, so.
In that case, right. I apologize for calling you Riaboros the entire night.
No, I like it. I like it because I like being called Ryu a lot too, because
it's Street Fighter.
Like the Western. Yeah, it's like the Western names. It's like Ryu. It's better. I like the sound of it better than Ru, because it's just like, it's like nothing there. It's just like you're saying R-U or something. Mm-hmm. But you can follow me there. Might be casting American Dota League. You can come check us out there. Greg, Cottle Guy, and Mott casting over there. I might be casting some of those games sometime. It's good. Good after the, like, it starts later than this, so we won't be stealing all your games, Toby. Join Dota's games. So you can come check us out.
It's fine. It's fine.
For teams, I'm not really playing on a team right now. Just waiting it out. So that's about it for right now.
The next pro player to turn into a caster. It starts now, peoples.
Starts now. All right, thanks for letting me cast. It was fun.
It's been wonderful, man. All right, we're going to wrap up tonight. Thanks for watching, peoples. If you still want to check out some live streams, the community channel is actually streaming out right now, as well as the JD Blue channel. They're doing some Gigabyte challenge, so definitely go check them out. Cap's working his ass off over on JD Blue. And, of course, I'll see you guys back here tomorrow night, 18 CEST, with our full Russian Empire versus VP. Thanks for watching.